I am Shane Needham. I'm laboratory director and co-founder at Alturas Analytics. And the thing that I'm most proud of in my testimony in life is that I'm a father of four great children, three boys and a wonderful daughter. My background is I've always loved science. Since the age of 12, I wanted to be an analytical chemist or a chemist of some kind. It always fascinated me. And I went to Washington State University, and that's where I did my undergraduate and received a bachelor's degree in chemistry. And then after my undergraduate, my wife and I moved to Rhode Island, Connecticut area, and I worked for Pfizer. And on the night, I'd work for Pfizer during the day, and then on the nights and the weekends, I would actually do my PhD dissertation and research and study on the nights and the weekends. So that was my main hobby at that point. And it was a really good way to do it because I could get industry experience. At the same time, I was still getting education. I co-founded Alturas Analytics because when I was at Pfizer, working at Pfizer, I worked in a great group there. Worked in the drug metabolism department, the mass spec bioanalytical group. And so what I do at Alturas, doing LC-MS-MS and GC-MS-MS, I did the same thing when I was at Pfizer. However, I saw a need there that there was not a CRO that was personalized and driving the science. And so I could see a niche there that I wanted to be a part of that. I always had the entrepreneurial spirit to start something. And I had some colleagues that I knew in the Washington, Idaho area, where we're located now in Moscow, Idaho, that I thought they'd be great business partners. And so four of us sat down in a restaurant. They kicked us out of the restaurant because it closed. We designed the logo and the name on a napkin and a cocktail napkin and decided what the future of Alturas would be like and how it was going to be funded and what would we do and what would our mission be and our vision. And so that need was, I think, always there, and it's still there for a personalized CRO with a personalized touch, but also driven by high science and high quality. The elements that I find are most rewarding of being a CRO is that we're part of the treatment to kill disease or to cure disease. And we actually have some awesome patient stories, even us, that we, for example, we work with a lot of oncology therapeutics, and we'll have excellent stories, sometimes even handwritten letters from that come through our sponsors that somebody that's been cured. And it's a project that we've actually worked on. I think that's the most rewarding, is that that's our overall mission, or our overall vision, or our dream, our purpose, is that we are part of that cure to really help patients. And the really cool part about it is, at the same time, we get to be chemists at heart. And I've always been a scientist at heart. I've always loved methods. I've always loved looking at molecules and developing methods and saying, oh, how can we improve this method? What technique should we use? So it's all part of not only just the mission of being an analytical chemist, but also the vision and the purpose of helping treat disease. I think the biggest challenge with a CRO, or even any business in general, especially in the world that we live in that's rapidly changing, is making sure you have the latest tools, whether it be the latest scientific instruments, whether that be LC-MS-MS or GC-MS-MS, or sometimes it's a part of an instrument that you put on an LC-MS, like a ion mobility or something like that to increase your selectivity, or using microflow to improve your methods, whatever it is, and trying to stay on top of all that. That's not only a challenge, but it's something that we thrive upon. We really, really love that because it's being a part of the community and being a scientist at heart. So not only helping treat disease, but we get to publish methods and techniques and so on and so forth. I think part of that, though, is always pleasing your sponsor. And in our world, that's in other worlds, that'd be called a client. But making sure that you're making sure that you develop relationships with them, and you keep those relationships, you maintain those relationships, and you're always making sure that they're a part of the process and you're all on the same collaborative team. And so it's certainly a challenge, but that's also the most rewarding part, is when that challenge comes together. One of the things I'm really excited about is one of the latest things that we are working on, and we've worked on and developed, is a system in our laboratory. It's an information management system called ALICE. And that stands for Alturas Laboratory Interface Communications and Equipment. And it manages all of our data in one location. It's been really, really great for our laboratory in improving the efficiency and the productivity. And really, the biggest thing is we've taken out the majority of the tribal knowledge, of what we like to call it. And instead of one person knowing where only one spreadsheet is, or the two or three spreadsheets, we have it all in one location. We can find it in one place, and it's easily accessible. And that's really, really exciting. I think we're hearing about a lot about what we do with data in our industry now, and how can we get that information to our patients ultimately faster? And Alice is a part of that. The impact of Alice, or a system where we integrate all of our data and all of our information into one information system, is huge. I mean, we can already see what it's done this compared to the standard practice, how most things are done in most CROs, by local CROs, to how we're doing it. We see improvements in efficiency and productivity, less error, less labor involved, less time involved. And so that's the impact, that it's more efficient, it's productive. And when we're more productive, when that happens, we save lives. We are able to deliver therapeutics with our sponsors on a more targeted, more minimized timeline. And that's what it's all about. Sure. Well, we try to always make sure that we remember what our purpose actually is. And our you know, a lot of people in a narrow way would be looking at our purpose is to develop analytical methods. And I mean, we can do that in the gas and oil industry, in the environmental industry, in the food science industry, and we can do that in pharma. But why are we doing it in pharma? Why are we doing it in biotech? It's to ultimately, the ultimate purpose is to save lives, to be a part of that cure. And that's what's exciting. We can't ever forget that purpose. And that's what really excites me every day to go to work.
Please tell me you still have that napkin somewhere.
We do.
Oh,
we
wow,
have that napkin.
Framed on the walls,
yeah. It's not framed. We take a picture of it and I bring it out for like our annual goals meeting, which I'm having next week actually.
Oh,
and so, yeah, it's really, really cool. Yeah.
That is really cool.